What are your thoughts on the concept of toxic masculinity, especially given the recent and tasteful Gillette commercial, the best a soy boy can get?
Yeah, I wasn't a big fan of that Gillette commercial. And there's just so much of that, just anti-male propaganda. And it hurts me because I wrote a book about boys. And I think most men, grown men, young men, just hear this crap and whatever. But little boys are getting this very negative message about who they are. And they're trying to pretend that normal maleness is a pathology or a disorder in need of a cure. And they're making a fundamental mistake, which is that there are men who are sort of pathologically masculine, boys who exhibit pathological masculinity. They show their maleness by hurting people, weaker people, and destroying things. But they're such a minority, a tiny percentage. The vast majority of men evince healthy masculinity, and they protect people, and they build, they don't destroy, and they channel their male exuberance and energy and risk-taking into constructive pursuits. And how did we lose sight of that? And so what we're doing is we're taking a small percentage of monsters and assuming that they are exemplars of the male sex, and then trying to, you know, teach little boys to educate them away from their boyness. Fortunately, the boys aren't cooperating, but it makes them, it's very confusing. So I don't like the idea of toxic masculinity, but if we are going to talk about toxic masculinity, then I think we have to talk about toxic femininity, because that exists too. There are sort of pathological, well, maybe pathological feminism, I should say, that I talked about tonight. I do think this is reckless and irresponsible, this radical thinking and the carelessness with facts, trying to implicate the average man in social atrocity, and then using all this as an excuse to ride roughshod over people's basic rights. And it's just a feminism I don't recognize. Feminism is supposed to be about liberation and happiness and fairness, equality with men. And now it's in many quarters becoming authoritarian and accusative and out to destroy men. So I do not favor the term toxic masculinity.